Look, Ramses. Look, it's water. It's okay, buddy. It's going to be all right. Yeah, look, Ramses. Water. You don't have to be afraid. See? It's okay.
Hey, babe. What are you doing?
I'm just trying to get Ramses here desensitized to water before his first time. So I'm showing him some pictures and videos and stuff.
I wonder what he really sees.
I wonder what else he's seen. Well, we may be in for a surprise today when he sees his first water jump on Evention today. I guess we'll see what happens.
Alright guys, welcome to Evention. Today we're going to talk about introducing a horse to the water. So this can either be a young horse or a horse that's a little bit spooky with the water. What you want to think about first is try and understand why the horse might not want to go into the water. It can be a bit murky, they might not be able to see the ground, they want to make sure that it's not too deep, and some horses just don't understand why they're even being asked. So patience is key with this exercise. If any of you saw the Liverpool video, it's real similar training tactics. What you want to think about is keeping your reins wide so you can funnel the horse into the water. Think about keeping the pressure on when the horse is thinking backwards and taking the pressure off when the horse is thinking forwards. So you want it to be a really good experience. Right now, I'm riding Final Susu, who's owned by Jen Holmquist. And she's a novice level event horse who's a little bit spooky about the water. Later, we're gonna have Dom ride a young horse who's never been in the water. So let's get started. Okay, a few things to remember when we're about to school a horse into the water. You wanna make sure that there's a ramp in. You don't wanna be trying to jump off a bank their first time. It's not even fair. The other thing you need to think about is having a very straight approach. You wanna make sure the horses can see where they're going and know that they're not gonna just have something come up all of a sudden. So I'm gonna start over here at the walk, not at the trot. If you'd start at the trot, if they end up pecking, you could go in the water. So just sitting behind the motion, letting her take a peek. Good girl. Yeah, good girl. Always lots and lots of praise when they come into the water. Good girl. Might even have a drink. All right, now on to the Evention Tip of the Day. Good girl. My tip for the day is something to help you out at the horse shows. At most competitions, it's required for you to have a bridle number on your horse anytime they're out of the stall. But most of the time, they only give you one of these nice, pretty little numbers. So what I do instead is I get white electrical tape and I wrap it around the cheek piece of the halter and then write the number on in permanent ink. That way, when you're bathing or grooming, you don't get your real number all screwed up. Back to the action.
Welcome back, guys. I'm riding Ramses today. He's a really cool little horse, but he's pretty inexperienced. He's only been an event horse for a couple of days. So we're gonna run through, give him a walk through the water, and then I'm gonna show you the next step. So basically, I'm gonna follow all the steps that Jimmy was telling us about. Pretty much the three most important things. We wanna build the trust for the horse. We want him to wanna take us through the water. So we're not trying to just get him in there and have him be scared. And have a tall upper body, open reins, legs on. Come on, boy. Oh, good boy, Ramses. And he's looking, he wants to take a look at the water. Just keep him moving forward and we're really happy with him. All right. Now, this is going to take it a step further for an inexperienced horse. Normally, I would sort of stay at this level for probably a week or two. But I'm going to show you the next step, which is putting him in over a lip or over a small drop. This changes things And judging by him, I think he's probably gonna take a little bit of a look here. And before I come in here, I'm gonna go through my little checklist. Very straight, open reins, eyes tall. Now this time, we may see the horse get a little bit nervous and leap in. Now he's the kind of horse that probably will, I'm not quite sure. So we gotta really think about our defensive position. And if you've caught our bank episodes and our Liverpool episodes, you'll know all about it. All right, mate, let's give this a try. So he's probably gonna take a little bit of a look. Now I'm gonna keep my eyes on the horizon. Come on, boy. Because I've been building trust, I'm pretty sure he'll go. Oh, good boy. And that's kind of an example of what some horses will do when they're a little bit unsure. If your position is there, he's gonna land without having a fright, and he's gonna be happy. All right, let's go to Schrammo Shout Out. Today's shout out goes to SquirrelWood Equine Sanctuary in Montgomery, New York. These guys have 20 to 25 horses at any given time that would be going to slaughter, and they give them tender, loving care. Eventioners, you guys are great on social media. They've got about 450 fans. I'd love for us to help boost them to 1,000. Check them out on Facebook and see how you can help. Okay, guys, I hope you picked up a few tips for introducing young horses to the water. Remember, patience is key. We gotta have our horses wanting to be comfortable and wanting to take us through. You don't need to beat a horse into the water to train him. You just gotta take your time. Best of luck with your water endeavors. See you next week.